it up. Michael Jordan for the tie. Got it! Unbelievable! Dreams to come true. This is March Madness.
It is a packed house in Tulsa, Oklahoma for our continuing coverage of third round action in the 2011 NCAA tournament. The winner here tonight makes its way to the Sweet 16. It's the number 9 seed, the Fighting Illini of Illinois, matching up with the number 1 seed, the Jayhawks of Kansas, the winner advancing to face the Spiders of Richmond in the Southwest Regional in San Antonio. Hi, everybody. I'm Marv Albert along with Steve Kerr. We'll be joined momentarily by Craig Sager working the sidelines. Kansas did not have an easy time in their second round match here on Friday night with the victory over Boston University, but they did pull away in the second half thanks to the play of the Morris twins, Markeith and Marcus.
Yeah, they were really good in the second half. And Marv, this is a Kansas team that really plays off of the twins. And Marcus has the ability to put the ball on the floor. He can step outside. Markeith, also very strong on the inside, can step out and shoot a three. Kansas plays inside out. They shoot 51% as a team, but everything revolves around these two guys. And then for Illinois, it's all about Dimitri McKamey. His play at the point guard spot loosens things up and allows people like Mike Davis to get open looks. Davis was terrific the other night, 22 points and 9 boards in that victory over UNLV.
And Steve, also a soap opera relationship between the two head coaches, with Bruce Weber taking over from Bill Self at Illinois. We'll have that and much more when we come back. Jayhawks and the Illini vying for a spot in the Sweet 16.
Coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament is sponsored by Northwestern Mutual, DirecTV, and by Southwest Airlines.
Back in Tulsa. And this will sound like a home crowd for the Kansas Jayhawks, just a 3.5-hour ride from Lawrence, as you look at the Fighting Illini of Illinois putting together one of its best performances of the season. The other night they beat UNLV, actually a blowout. Illinois had come in as a struggling team, losing 10 of the previous 16. UNLV had won 6 of its previous 7, but a different story on Friday night. And look at the starting lineup for the Kansas Jayhawks, 33-2, 14-2 in the Big 12. The two losses at home against Texas in January at Kansas State. In mid-February, they have won 9 straight. The head coach is Bill Self. In his 8th season with Kansas, he has ties to the Tulsa area. One-time head coach at Oral Roberts, one-time head coach at Tulsa, and one-time head coach at Illinois, preceding Bruce Weber.
A lot of subplots here tonight, and we'll get into some of that later on. But to start this game, Marv, what I'm really looking for is, can Illinois play that style of offense and get out in space and have flow and rhythm like they did against UNLV? Kansas, a much better defensive club than the Running Rebels. Kansas will be very physical with this Illinois front line and with Dimitri McKamey.
High-definition television broadcast from March Madness provided by LG. The officiating crew, Joe DeRosa, Brian Dorsey, Burt Smith. Illinois in control. And this is McKamey with it, watched by Tyshawn Taylor. The ball will be in the hands of McKamey most of the way. Mike Davis rims out, and it's handled by Taylor. Here comes the Jayhawks. The Morris is on the block. This is Marcus.
Well, right away, the cross match in transition. KU getting out and running, and McKamey ends up on Morris. And he just takes advantage of the smaller defender.
And here is McKamey. That's a three. He shoots 46% from downtown.
He's the X factor for Illinois. He always is. Taylor inside gets it to go. But everybody you talk to, whether it's opposing coaches or even Bruce Weber, say, when does Illinois play well? Well, when McKamey plays well.
Illinois had not won two straight games since back in January. They started the season well in the Big Ten and then went into the tailspin. Davis, Mike Davis, who had a terrific all-around game the other night. 22 points, 9 rebounds, 5 assists. Markieff Morris called for steps. Well, we had a stirring first game earlier here in Tulsa with Arizona getting by Texas in the final second, 70-69, with the Wildcats advancing to take on Duke in Anaheim on the West Regional next Thursday.
It was an incredible finish. We're going to see an offensive foul here on Brandon Paul. But what an amazing finish to that game. Looked like Texas had it wrapped up, and the ball and a 2-point lead, 12 seconds left. That 5-second violation opened up the door, and the Wildcats take advantage. Incredible finish.
Derek Williams with the winning bucket. He had been struggling, finished with 17 points, 9 rebounds, finished with a 3-point play. We'd like to give a special welcome to all of our troops around the world watching the tournament on the American Forces Network. See the double team. And it's a tie-up. Possession arrow pointing in the direction of Kansas.
And Mark, one of the interesting themes here for Kansas will be how loose are they going to be? You know, their second round loss to Northern Iowa has been well documented. It's actually 1 year ago today, also known as Rukmanesh Day,
yes.
I believe.
Yes.
But, you know, there's been so much pressure on this Kansas program. Not only with that loss, but a couple of losses in 05 and 06 to Bucknell and Bradley, and a lot of criticism for Bill Self and his club losing early at times. Of course, they won the national championship 3 years ago. They've had tremendous success, but it's a team that has looked a little tight here early in the tournament.
Markieff Morris at the line, fouled by Bill Cole. Well, you recall at halftime of the game the other night in Boston University, Kansas up by only 4 points. Bill Self telling our Craig Sager, we look tight. But I don't know what's going on. We have a 4-point lead.
It was interesting seeing some of the quotes from the Kansas players the last couple days talking about their feelings as maybe can't get the three to go. But Tyshawn Taylor said, look, you know, you want to be loose, but the stakes are so high, it's hard to just say, let's be loose.
Markieff Morris with a straightaway three.
Looks pretty loose to start. Kansas coming out with some energy and some aggressiveness.
Not bad for a player at 6'10". He shoots 41% from beyond that three-point line.
He loves that trailing three that he can step into.
Tisdale pops it back out. Paul. Kansas on the run, led by Markieff Morris. That's a three-point attempt. Tyrell Reed, who shoots the three at 41%. Kansas off to the quick start. They've hit 4 of their first 5 shots.
They look a lot more like themselves. Intense defensive pressure all over the floor. Solid defense. They've played inside out. They've knocked down shots in transition.
McKinney draws the foul. He wants a goaltend. Will not get the call.
Now here's Markieff Morris in transition. He hit that same shot against Boston U the other day to really break that game open in the second half. That trailing three, and you see why he is such a gifted player. Big, strong, can rebound, and then step out and shoot a 24-footer.
Adrian McKamey, a 73% free throw shooter. The Warriors of Marquette, the Orange Men of Syracuse, playing right now in Cleveland, and that game is over on True TV. Gus Johnson, Len Elmore, Marty Snyder bringing it to you, and they are all tied up. Deflected out. Last touch by Davis of Illinois. You mentioned the anniversary on this 20th day of March. Today, the anniversary of last season's second round, 69-67. Kansas lost to Northern Iowa in the second round on that 3-point barrage by Ali Farouk-Manesh.
A lot of parallels, too. That game was down the road in Oklahoma City, and their first round matchup on the opposite side of bracket was UNLV. Now, they lost to Northern Iowa, but kind of, you know, a lot of parallels. Oklahoma UNLV in the second round possible, and all of a sudden they come out against Boston U. They play a very tight first half. So this is all about just not getting in their own way here today, because they're the better team.
As you say, Bill Self did win a title here just a few years back. Tisdale able to keep it alive back in 2008.
You know what's amazing about this, Marv, is the turnover, and Tyshawn Taylor will have the easy two. You know what amazes me about the NCAA tournament? You lose a couple games early and it becomes this stigma, and that's almost all anybody remembers. Kansas over the last 10 years has more NCAA tournament victories than anybody in the country, and yet if you ask people, they think, they lose a lot in the early rounds.
Davis came up short. It's a different type of game for Davis. Not getting the space he did the other day. Reed for three. And rebounded by Davis.
Well, Marv, you're exactly right. That UNLV game was tailor-made for this Illinois team, as McCain can't get the three to go. But UNLV was trapping all over the place, and it actually played into Illinois' hands because they were able to space the floor. They have very skilled players and shooters, and they got wide open looks because they handled the pressure. Kansas will defend much more like a Big Ten team. Straight man-to-man. They're not going to give Illinois any space. They're going to be very physical.
Morningstar. Taylor with room for three. Yes. The Jayhawks start out with a first. A 12-1 run by Kansas.
Double in New York with a tournament update for you. Over on True TV in Cleveland, Syracuse on an 8-1 run. Deion Waiters with a three, 46-41 over Big East rival Marquette, under 13 minutes to play in the second half. Back to Tulsa, Marv Albert.
Hawk, thank you, Greg. Kansas opened up by hitting six of their first nine, three from beyond the three-point line. Illinois struggling, only 2 of 8 here at the start. Six minutes in. Jeff Ridley, who just come on, a 7-foot. I'll check that. Myers Leonard, who had come on, has called for the offensive foul.
Has endured because the car has. Only one car can be called the most durable, longest lasting in its class. Presenting the One, the 34 mile per gallon Accord from Honda.
Welcome back to Tulsa. Kansas leads by 10. Bruce Weber is facing Bill Self for the first time since he took over for him at Illinois in 2003. Initially, Bruce Weber had a hard time getting support from the fans and respect from the players. After an early struggle, he decided to dress all in black from head to toe. After a game, he announced to his team and to the fans that they had attended a mock funeral. that they had buried the legacy of Bill Self. He said yesterday maybe he was a little overdramatic, but it seemed to work. He had to do something to sever the ties with the, quote, self-obsession.
Self-obsession.
I like that.
Very good, Craig. What a move by Elijah Johnson just a moment ago. And when Bruce Weber yesterday at the news conference was asked another question about Bill Self, he said, I'm just worried about Kansas.
Yeah, exactly. You know, what's interesting about that is Bruce Weber took this school to the Final Four, in fact, the final game.
Whoa, what a...
How'd that go?
What a hop. Brandon Paul with a very friendly rim. And it's the 1-2 our left. That was the case here Friday night for
The
doubleheaders. That stopped a 14-1 run by Kansas.
But to get back to Weber, he had tremendous success right off the bat with Illinois. Went to the Sweet 16 in 04 in the championship game where they lost to North Carolina in 05. Foul there on Leonard. And how does this go? Straight up. It's unbelievable. That's the highest shot I've ever seen bounce off a rim and go back in. Incredible.
Selby and Robinson have just checked in for Kansas. Paul deflects to the backcourt. Morningstar is on. Thomas Robinson, beautiful move. Whoa. Sophomore from Washington, D.C. takes right to the rim.
And Kansas with a major physical edge on the front line over Illinois. And a much more finesse team, especially with guys like Tisdale and Davis.
Mike Tisdale with his first bucket. Selby looking for Robinson down low. Kansas jumping in front here, 22-11. The pass intended for Robinson.
Marcus Morris had Selby wide open in the corner. He made the wrong read.
That time not a friendly rim for DJ Richardson, who just come on. 11.5 remaining. In the first half, Kansas up by 9. Selby on that foul. Look at the tournament summary. In fact, the winner here between Kansas and Illinois advancing to the Sweet 16 will face the Spiders of Richmond, who defeated Morehead State yesterday. Richmond with that victory. Morehead State coming off the upset of Louisville. North Carolina beating Washington. What a wild finish that was.
Sure was. And then VCU, talk about redemption for the committee. How they took so much heat for the VCU selection. Yeah, but it they obviously proved them right, having quite a run.
Mike Tisdale at the line. Another close game over on True TV. Marquette and Syracuse at a one-point affair playing right now in Cleveland over on True TV. Kansas by 7.
I'll tell you, the other interesting game tonight would be Notre Dame, Texas A&M. Imagine if A&M wins that game. The winner of this game will have the other three teams in the region be VCU, Richmond, and Texas A&M. Who could have ever picked out? I'm guessing President Obama even didn't pick out.
Marcus Morris not able to hit. Illinois trying to settle things down.
Well, if I said Texas A&M, it's actually Florida State against Notre Dame. But same thing. I mean, nobody could have predicted that.
Davis with the runner. Rebounded by Robinson for Kansas. Elijah Johnson, played by McKinney. Kansas turnover.
Illinois much better energy at the defensive end right now.
Tisdale likes that spot.
Ooh, halfway down.
Sean Taylor, junior out of Hoboken, New Jersey, averages 9 points, 5 assists. Taylor off the head fake. And that's a charge. Offensive foul.
I'll tell you what, well, Illinois has weathered the storm here. And you mentioned it early, but we might as well be playing in Lawrence, you know, given this crowd. 90% Jayhawk fans, and they were so emotional early. And Illinois kind of weathered the storm. They're down seven. They've gotten much better defensively now, and Bruce Weber's club seems to have gotten this crowd under control as well. So see if we can get a couple hoops and kind of get this thing right back to even.
A raucous scene during the introduction of the Kansas lineups.
Oh, man. And everybody in blue. There's just one pocket of Illinois orange.
Maybe fires cross court. Intended for Richardson, but overthrown.
Kansas really mixing it up on McKamey. They started out with Tyshawn Taylor, and we're also seeing Elijah Johnson. So Bill Self trying to put his most athletic players and rotate them onto McKamey and continue to put pressure on him.
Here's Morningstar, Reed. This is Johnson with the runner. The save by Robinson, but picked off. It's a traveling violation, says Joe DeRosa. Dimitri McKamey on that attempted save called for steps.
How about the save from Thomas Robinson? So athletic. And then McKamey gathers it, but good call from DeRosa. And Robinson will take a seat.
Well, as Bruce Weber telling us yesterday, he says when we don't play well, it usually depends on McKamey because Dimitri sometimes does not deal very well with success.
He said when he gets going, all of a sudden, you know, he'll have a couple good games and then he takes a step back with his work ethic. And he's kind of gone at it a little bit.
That counts. And the foul, Marcus Morris with the bucket. And he'll head to the line. He's hit by Tisdale.
Well, good ball movement and then the angle, perfect pass to Marcus. He might have gotten away with a little bunny hop there. I didn't see that live, but he gets the finish, the reaction from Johnson and Kansas playing pretty well. You know, what I'm most impressed with this team, Marv, is their spacing offensively. And I think Morningstar and Reed don't get a lot of headlines. But they're just smart players. They shoot the ball well. They're always making good decisions, and they space the floor. And then the Morris twins, as I mentioned earlier, Kansas plays off of those guys. They get good shots every trip down. That's why they shoot 51% as a team, which leads the nation.
Tisdale getting inside. Tisdale goes 7-1, 250 pounds, but he is most effective from the perimeter. Yeah,
it's a pick and pop guy, and he's got a beautiful shooting stroke. But when you get him in a physical confrontation with guys like Markieff or Marcus Morris, he's at a disadvantage. That's not really his game.
Shot clock down to seven. McKamey with a long three.
Settling a little bit early here. McKamey has taken a few of those long distance shots. He's got to get the ball on the floor and get penetration for his teammates.
Reed with the step. Kept alive by Morningstar. Still plenty of time on the clock. And stepped out.
Incredible play from Tyrell Reed. I don't know how he got that ball. It looked like Illinois was going to have a fast break at the other end. But they recovered quickly, the Illini did, and made a nice defensive play to force Morris out of bounds.
And Bill Cole will come on for Dimitri McKamey. Mentioned those three-point shots. McKamey 1 of 4 from downtown. So Illinois in possession. The Fighting Illini out of the Big Ten. They had come into the tournament having their difficulties. They'd lost 10 of their previous 16 games. Came up very big the other night because of that man, Mike Davis, was able to bank it home. He had a strong game against UNLV.
He is very skilled. He's got about an 18-foot range on his jump shot. As Reed pump fakes. Nice play, but can't get the jumper to go. But Davis, very important right now on the floor without McKamey out there. He has to take over the offense.
That was a three-point attempt. Off the mark. Tisdale not able to get to it. Rebounded by Markieff Morris. That's number 5 for Markieff. he's looking to fire away. Good ball movement here by Kansas. Markieff Morris, yes, in the foul. Morris to the line. Davis called on the foul. Kansas edge to the lead, up 25-15.
Coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament is sponsored by Miller Lite, UPS, and by Chevrolet.
Check out the Powerade IM 4-point performance ranking system to get a peek into the science behind tournament success. See where your team ranks at NCAA.com/Powerade.
And take a look at the difference between Friday night against UNLV and tonight in the first half. The numbers against the Rebels were off the charts, but as I mentioned earlier, it was a totally different type of defense that they saw. The UNLV was trapping all over the floor, and that allowed these finesse Illinois players to find space, and they moved the ball beautifully and found open looks. Kansas being much more physical here and staying at home. It's just one-on-one, man-to-man.
And a good start for the Morris twins. That's not the case the other night. Tisto gets it down low. Nice. That'll count. That's a goaltend. And perhaps a foul. Nice pass from Tisdale finding Davis.
Yeah, great pass over the top. And Davis able to seal his man. He had the smaller Mario Little on him. And Kansas with a very small lineup on the floor right now. Illinois recognizing that and taking advantage.
Foul on Little. 3-point play for Davis, the senior out of Alexandria, Virginia, coming off an excellent game the other night. Kansas up 26-18. Morningstar had no angle. The tip missed by Robinson. Brandon Paul controls.
Interesting lineup right now for Bill Self. You don't often see Marcus and Markieff off the court at the same time, and he's really going with kind of four guards and Thomas Robinson. Mario Little, kind of a swing man, I guess you could say, but he's playing the four right now.
Davis, that's the shot he was hitting the other night against UNLV, so Illinois battling back into it.
And Bruce Weber recognizing that smaller mismatch. That's twice in a row now they've gone to Davis, and it's paid off.
Robinson with the step. Rebound Little. Good job by Mario Little, senior from Chicago. Just under 6 minutes to go in this first half. Marv Albert, Steve Kerr, Craig Sager, we're in Tulsa. It is a packed house, better than 17,000 on hand.
Boy, look at Bill Cole with that offensive board.
Davis trying to get it down low, but overthrew Tisdale.
And Tisdale just can't get position against Robinson. Robinson just too big for him down there. But meanwhile, Davis does have the size advantage over Mario Little, and he scored a couple times. And Bill Self has seen enough of that lineup. He's going to go back to the Morris twins.
Markieff, 7 points, 5 rebounds. And Marcus Morris, 5-3. You saw Mike Davis's numbers. Morris trying to set it up for his brother.
It was there, too. The pass was just a little high, but it was really well-executed action.
Nice play, but it's turned back. Tisdale is there for the foul.
He should have gotten a call on a foul, too. It looked like he was pushed in the back by Marcus Morris, but he still gets it to go.
And the Illinois portion of the crowd responds. The Illini now within six. Check of the game summary, although Illinois just 8 for 22 from the field. They're down by just 6 points.
Yeah, they battled back here. This little stretch here the last couple minutes was really important to kind of keep them within range. But the bad news for Illinois, Dimitri McKamey hasn't gotten anything going. And as we talked about, he's really the key to this club. They can't win unless he gets it going.
Of a wee. This is Elijah Johnson. Mike Morningstar. Shot clock down to 7. Deflected out. Last touch by Illinois.
You know, Marv, I would say if there's a weakness to Kansas's team, they don't have a creator on the perimeter that can really break down the defense in late clock situations.
A 7 on the shot clock. Kansas is led by as many as 12 points. Marcus Morris unable to get the roll.
Good defense by Illinois. If they can work the clock defensively and not let Kansas score early, they get them in late clock situations. Kansas is vulnerable because of that, the lack of that go-to guy.
Richardson played by Reed. Davis looking for help. Takes a timeout.
I think Bruce Weber was calling for the timeout. He was yelling at him from the sidelines. Interesting call.
Coming up on AT&T at the half, we'll get you all caught up in all the latest tournament news, highlights, and updates. All coming up on AT&T at the half. Illinois able to get back into it. Kansas red hot at the start. Led by the count of 18-6 at one stretch. Just under 4 remaining in this first half. Richardson, yes, that's a 3 for DJ Richardson.
Big shot for him. He was the Big Ten Freshman of the Year last year, but it's been a struggle this season as Morningstar gets the reverse lay-in. But Marv, Richardson is a really key guy for this Illinois team. When he scores, it kind of softens things up defensively, and it allows more space for McKamey and the bigs.
Morningstar ending a 10-2 Illinois run. Davis looking it over. Tisdale down low. Here is Tisdale. Collision between Tisdale and Markieff Morris.
Yeah, but Tisdale just doesn't have the strength to get position down there. He's forced out, and that jump hook becomes 12 feet instead of 8.
Here is Markieff Morris called for the charge. A push out as Tisdale went to the floor.
And that's how you have to play if you're Tisdale. You don't have the physical advantage, so get position. But meanwhile, how about Brady Morningstar? The reverse lay-in. Nice move.
Down by 7. Final play for Detroit.
Only thing that would make this any better is overtime.
They'll need a miracle to win this football game. Aaron slot right, drops back. Hines takes the pass at the 30. With the seam! Wow! Can you believe it? One man to beat! We're headed to overtime!
Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
Field goal for the win!
Cardiology, I don't have the heart. Pulmonary doctor, no cigar. I can't diagnose a simple cold or flu, but if your engine's got a cough, I know what to do. Give it 6 of these and wash it down with this. A new air filter ought to help it catch its breath.
So your seat good? Get the mirrors all adjusted. You can see everything okay? Just stay off the freeways, all right? I don't want you going out on those yet. Just leave your phone in your purse. I don't want you texting.
Okay? Daddy, okay.
Okay. There you go. Be careful.
Thanks, Dad.
Call me, but not while you're driving.
We knew this day was coming.
That's why we bought a Subaru.
Greg Gumbel in New York with a tournament update for you. Marquette and Syracuse. Jay Crowder of Marquette with a three. He has 14 points. They are tied at 59 with 50 seconds to play in regulation. Back to Tulsa.
All right, thank you, Greg. And the winner would head to The Rock to face North Carolina in the Sweet 16.
The Rock.
The Rock, Prudential Center, Newark, New Jersey. Just under three left in this first half. We're in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Illinois getting back into it. They're down by five. They're in possession. Tisdale sets the screen. Shot clock at five. McCandy with the air ball. Here comes Tyrell Reed.
They've just done a terrific job on McCandy. Staying in front of him. The guards are guarding him and staying in front of him. And the bigs, when they need to help, are also keeping him from penetrating. He's had nowhere to go.
Marcus Morris, played by Mike Davis. Poked away, nearly stolen, recovered by Reed. Keith Morris with five on the shot clock. And a foul in the act. Every tournament game is live online on your iPhone or iPad with NCAA March Madness on demand. For details, go to mmod.ncaa.com. Tisdale on the foul. That is his second. Mike Tisdale leading the Big Ten in that department. Personal fouls.
I was surprised that Markeith Morris was awarded two shots on that. I thought it was going to be one and one, but apparently they gave him the continuation. Looked like it was a bump out on the perimeter.
Markeith Morris averaging 13 points, 8 rebounds, just under 70% at the line. Kansas by six. Markeith with 8 points.
What can Illinois do to get McCamey going? Maybe they take him off the ball. That's what they're doing here. Can they run him off a screen and maybe get him on a catch and shoot situation?
Davis, nice play.
Ooh.
Mike Davis again. He has 11 points. Yeah,
thank goodness for Mike Davis if you're an Illini fan. And he's keeping them in this right now.
Markeith Morris coming up short. Played well. Crossover move by Davis, and as Paul makes his move, he's hit by Selby. Marquette up by three over Syracuse with 16 seconds remaining over on True TV.
How about that? Another Big East third round matchup. With so many teams in the Big East this year that you're seeing a couple early round matchups with their conference teams. Interesting.
That's a three-point attempt by Brandon Paul. Final minute, first half. Johnson gets it down low. Markeith Morris has had a terrific first half. That's 10 points.
Bad shots lead to poor transition defense. Paul just jacking as Richardson gets the two-pointer to go. But Paul cannot settle for long-range shots. That's not really his game. He's an okay three-point shooter, but he's at his best when he puts the ball on the floor. But you take a bad one when your defense is exposed at the other end.
About a four-second differential as this first half winds down. And they'll play it out. Elijah Johnson looking over at head coach Bill Self. Down to five. Marcus Morris. Final seconds of the half. They have to hurry. McCamey gave it up. Too late. DJ Richardson's shot was late. And that is the end of the first half. Kansas led by as many as 12. Illinois making a run to get back into it. Halftime here in Tulsa. And the Jayhawks with a 33-29 lead. Illinois ends the half with a 14-7 spurt. The high point player for Kansas is Markieff Morris. 10 points.
Is sponsored by AT&T, the nation's fastest mobile broadband network.
Once again, everybody, I'm Ernie Johnson. Welcome to AT&T at the half. After 20 minutes of play in Tulsa, Kansas, one of the number one seeds, leading Illinois 33-29. I'm joined by Greg Anthony, Kenny the Jet Smith, Charles Barkley, and Rick Pitino, the head coach of Louisville. What'd you make of the first 20 minutes of that one, Greg?
Impressive by Illinois to get back in the game, down 12 early on. You know, I was impressed with how Illinois played against UNLV, the way they should have played early in the season. Kansas, a lot of people's pick to get to a Final Four and win the national championship. Talented and deep, but Bill Self has said it before. Their guard play at times has been erratic, Coach. It's going to be critical for them to take care of the basketball here in the second half.
And they're not shooting a high percentage, and you're right there. You shoot 39%, let the other team shoot 50, and you're only down a few points. They're right in the game.
You're impressed with the Morris brothers, Chuckster?
One of them tonight so far. I call them the law firm, Morris and Morris. But I agree with Greg. They got to do a much better job of hitting some outside shots, freeing up the middle, give them a little room to work.
You're shaking your head at the Morris brothers or Morris and Morris?
What law firm do you know?
There's so many.
Morris and Morris.
There's so many jokes
me,
behind
Coach,
that.
I've had a lot of lawyers in my life.
That's my There was the joke I was going for. That's the joke I was going for. But no,
I was always found not guilty.
Thank you for setting the record straight.
That is straight.
Many not aware of that.
Yeah, I think the one thing you look at is the Kansas versatility. Is it going to hold up? And, the Morris law firm is doing a great job inside. And then their guard play just is the versatility, because they remind me of Ohio State, but the smaller version of that, because I think on the perimeter, they're not as big as Ohio State, but the versatility that they have around the perimeter is what really gets you.
4-point lead for Kansas at the break. A few moments ago, we showed you the finish of that game between Marquette and Syracuse. It was a thriller with Gus Johnson at the mic. Here are the highlights with Gus's call.
Watch Waiters, the freshman, and he turned it over. Butler, the kick, DJ, Jardine for three. DeJunga with the rebound, and Marquette has it. He misses a second. Jackson had it, can't hold on, and that will do it. Marquette. Third-seeded Syracuse on a Darius Johnson Odom cold jumper, 66-62. Wow.
Syracuse lost in the Sweet 16 last year to Butler. They don't make the Sweet 16 this time around, as Marquette does, 66-62. You heard him say DJO, Darius Johnson Odom, with a couple of big threes in that and finish with 17 points. You know these teams so well, Coach. Does this surprise you?
Well, now you know how Jamie Dixon feels. Syracuse shoots 55% and they lose because of the 19 turnovers. But just goes to show you how strong the Big East is, because this is the last team to get in, and now they move on to the Sweet 16.
You're right. Last team to get in, beat the number, but the high seed. That tells you actually how top-heavy those teams. People were complaining about VCU, Georgia, and teams getting in. The Big East should have never got 11 teams in. They got some well, good.
Then Marquette wouldn't have made it.
Listen, they beat Syracuse. Twice. That tells you Syracuse wasn't that good. That's my point. Listen, the Big East was just overrated, and after Notre Dame lose tonight, it's just going to be another feather in my cap.
Well, I'm going to say Notre Dame will not lose tonight. I'm on record with that one with you. They will not lose.
You said they're going to have two teams in the Final Four?
I said one or two teams are going to make the Final Four, and I gave you the bracket to save at the end.
I'm going to say this.
Hey, Charles, look at this score.
Listen.
It's 14-9 FSU over Notre Dame.
Let me make this one thing.
Please make it.
I think that the Big East have the best coaches in college basketball. I think they have the least amount of talent. They got some good teams, some good solid teams. That's it. None of them anything to write home about. I think Connecticut probably has the one great player, But the rest of those teams were good, solid players who had great coaching.
So if you had your choice, how many Big East teams would you have put in?
Eight.
Eight teams. And then you would have gotten three from other conferences and just kind of filled it up.
Yes. Instead of listening to people complain about, you know, people who complain that VCU would have won.
So that means, I see what you're saying. So since VCU is going doing well in the tournament, the two wins that they had over other teams in their conference shouldn't have been held against them because that's a good team.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying the Big East is a good. Oh, thank you. You're right.
Okay. All right. I was helping you with that.
The Big East deserved 11 teams.
This segment presented by
the. We don't call it the Big East.
Morris & Morris Law Firm. For all your legal needs. We'll be back with more.
AT&T at the Half is sponsored by AT&T, the nation's fastest mobile broadband network. Coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament is sponsored by the Capital One Venture Card, the new Windows Phone, LG, and by Infinity.
Back in Tulsa, Marv Albert, Steve Kerr, Craig Sager, 4-point Kansas lead. Let's check in with Craig.
Well, Coach, after falling behind by a dozen, defensive stops got you back into the game. What are the keys here in the second half?
Well, just playing good basketball. We didn't take care of the basketball. We made some bad decisions. Once we got kind of settled down, maybe got the jitters out, we played good defense, like you say, but we got to make good decisions on the offensive end, get it to our shooters in the right spots.
All right, thanks a lot. Thank you, Marv.
A moment ago, we were talking about their point guard, Dimitri McCamey, who had a terrific game the other night against UNLV. And as Bruce Weber had told us yesterday, sometimes he does not follow up, go back to back. And that's been the story in the first half.
Yeah, it's been the story of his season. Really inconsistent play. Spectacular the other night against UNLV. But this is a different defense. Kansas playing him straight up, playing him very physically. And they're getting a lot of help from their bigs, really not giving McCamey any room to roam.
He hit his first shot, missed his last five. Meanwhile, for Kansas, the Marcus twins have done very well. Markeef and Marcus have led the way for the Jayhawks.
Really remarkable when you look at the stats that Illinois is actually within four and now two as Tisdale knocks down the jumper. You know, Illinois shot 39% in that first half. Kansas at 54%. But Kansas turned it over eight times. They didn't get shot attempts in that last 5 minutes.
Nice pass inside from Morningstar. Markeef Morris with 12 points. Kansas back to a 4-point lead. Here is Tisdale. That was a 3-point attempt. Rebounded by Marcus Morris. Big contingent here from Lawrence, Kansas. Fires for three, and it's rebounded by Cole. It's only about a 3.5-hour drive, so they are well represented by family, friends, and fans. Nice move again by Davis. Mike Davis has 13.
Now, we talked early in the telecast, Marv, about the pressure on this Kansas team. And the longer that Illinois can stay close, you wonder if Kansas won't start thinking about things, but Marcus Morris off to the nice start here in the second half.
Marcus Morris, the Big 12 Player of the Year. Strong move by Cole, and that'll put him at the line. Cole, an 81% free throw shooter, the co-captain, senior out of Peoria, Illinois. A programming reminder, fear the skies, face the enemy, fight for survival from TNT and DreamWorks Television. Falling Skies, series premiere this June only on TNT. You know, you go back to Friday night, Kansas involved, number one seed against the 16th seed, Boston University. They win at 72-53, but had only a 4-point lead at halftime. Now, certainly the quality of opposition a little bit different here with Illinois, but himself not happy about what took place Friday night. Felt his team was tight. And once again, it's just a 4-point lead at halftime.
And it seems like it should be a lot more. And Morris on the slap. Beautiful pick and roll action with Tyshawn Taylor. Markeef Morris. Emphatic.
14 points for Markeef. Tisdale was hit by Markeef Morris.
Look at this action, the high pick, and then most of the defense focusing on Marcus Morris, and Markieff rolls to the rim, and great find from Taylor.
How about Marquette defeating Syracuse, the third team of a number 11 seed or lower to reach the Sweet 16. Joining Richmond, VCU, brings back some memories of that 1977 final. Al McGuire's Marquette team defeating Dean Smith's North Carolina Tar Heels for the championship. Marquette will go up against North Carolina.
Butch Lee on that team?
Oh, yes. Al McGuire used to. Oh, nice play. Marcus Morris on the layup. Al used to get involved in locker room fights with his own players. 2.5 gone by. Second half. Three-pointer for DJ Richardson.
Big one. I mean, you could feel the momentum slipping away for Illinois, and that shot right there just brings them right back.
Morningstar called for the charge. Try to split through. It's an offensive foul.
Now take a look. Morningstar on his way. Tisdale, feet set. Great call by the official. Tisdale, nice job helping. And, you know, defense is really all about how well your fours and fives can react in rotations. The guards have to know that their bigs are going to be there. Illinois, an excellent defensive club. When you look at the numbers, really remarkable. They hold their opponents to 40% shooting, 30% from the three-point line. A lot of that is their bigs are so active.
Tyrell Reed able to pull it down. Get it down in a hurry. That's a goaltend on Tisdale. So the basket counts. Make it 16 for Markieff Morris.
Kansas doing an excellent job pushing the ball in transition and getting the Morris twins the ball. Yeah, it hit the backboard first. Good call by the officials. But I like the pace with which Kansas is playing.
The Morris twins have accounted for all 10 Kansas points here at the start of the second half. Richardson got the step and then popped it out. Tisdale for three, way off. Kept alive by Paul. Davis looking down low. Tisdale unable to operate in close. And it's deflected out. The officials checking with each other, and it's called Kansas ball. Bruce Weber does not agree.
I think Marcus Morris got this ball thrown off of Tisdale. Let's take a look, but look, he's out of bounds. And the Illinois fans justifiably upset as they see the replay here in the arena. Marcus Morris was a foot out of bounds.
Taylor. Tisdale pulls it down. Ball off the cut, had nowhere to go. Deflected out, last touch by the Jayhawks. Leading to a timeout, we are in downtown Tulsa. The winner here heads to the Sweet 16.
Light beer, please.
Sure. More taste or less taste?
I don't really care.
Okay. When you change out of that European man thong, come back and I'll give you a Miller Lite.
But it's stylish.
Not in this country.
Man up and choose a light beer with more taste. Grab a triple hops brewed Miller Lite with that great Pilsner taste.
Got a Miller Lite?
Look! We had a scene! Roll there!
Greg Gumbel in New York with a tournament update for you. Over on TBS in Chicago, FSU and Notre Dame doing battle. Luke Blount's going to give FSU its biggest lead at 23-11, but Notre Dame has scored the last 5 points to close it. Let's get you back to Tulsa and Marv Albert.
All right, thank you, Greg. And the winner will move on to the Sweet 16 in San Antonio to face VCU. Illinois able to hang around. We're early second half. Trailed by as many as 12. Shot clock under 10. McCamey trying to use the pick. Three on the clock. That three way off by Richardson and now kept alive.
That ball just clipped the rim. So the Illini get a new shot clock to work with.
Paul was looking for a three. Here's Paul. Marcus Morris and Markeith Morris have dominated in the second half. That was intended. Down low for Marcus Morris, who was shaken up.
Great help from McCamey. The Kansas fans curious. They thought he should have been called for the foul on Marcus Morris coming over from the weak side. And when he poked the ball away, Marcus Morris takes a shot here, but it's really on the follow through. I think that's a good no call. He gets the ball first. It didn't really affect the play.
Took the shot in the chest.
Yeah.
Marcus and Markeith have combined to hit 5 of 5 from the field for 10 points over the first 5 minutes of this second half.
And they've been working this kind of high-low game in the second half, either from the top or from the wing with post feeds from Morningstar and Tyrell Reed. They've done an excellent job of taking advantage of their biggest strength over the Illini defense, which is the Morris twins down low. They have a big physical edge down there. They've got to keep pounding the ball.
Oh, he may have been clipped in the lip also. Steve, look at the Kansas shooting. That's the mom, Angel. Angel Morris. Kansas is 18 of 31 from the field, 58%. They lead the nation in field goal percentage. They shoot a sizzling 51, just under 40 from three-point range. Here is Reed for three. Rebounded by Tisdale.
Well, beautifully executed play that Bill Self called out of the huddle, and that was money wide open, and it was right on the back rim. That would have brought this crowd down.
Tisdale on a double. Trying to wheel in.
It's not his game.
Markeith Morris not able to get to that pass. Nice save. Bodies falling all over the court. DJ Richardson just hit the deck.
The hustle from McCamey. Back-to-back plays defensively.
McCamey looking for the shot. Able to swing away. He cannot find the touch.
Just not much space. You know, everywhere he turns, he's got a defender coming at him. The other night, he was flying all over the court. He could go anywhere he wants. And now McCamey needs a rest. He just signaled over to Bruce Weber that he needs a little rest here.
Markeith Morris. It's a three-point attempt rebounded by Tisdale. McCamey is only 1 of 7 from the field. Hit his first shot, and that's been it. After an outstanding game the other night against the Running Rebels. Foul is called away from the ball.
Now this is why McCamey is tired. He's been flying all over the court defensively, doing an excellent job. And he's going to get a minute here. And there's an under 12 TV timeout. And maybe Bruce Weber will try to keep him out until then. Give him a good chance to catch his breath.
Randall Head comes on for the first time. Freshman out of Madison, Illinois, the brother of Luther Head. Kansas foul on Thomas Robinson.
Luther, of course, one of the stars on that 2006 NCAA championship finalist.
Question as to who deflected it out. That pass thrown along the baseline. And the officials confer with each other. They say last touched by Kansas.
Can you tell we're in Kansas territory?
It feels like a Kansas home game, although Illinois does have a contingent on hand.
That's a good call. Looks like Selby just got a finger on it. And a nice job by the officials conferring and getting it right.
Davis down low. Paul.
Boy, this activity by the Kansas defense, impressive.
Clock to 7.
Can't find a shot. No, they do. Beautiful pass from Head finding Cole on the back door.
That's what we saw the other night, Marv, against UNLV when the Rebels were pressing on the perimeter and really forcing the Illini defense out. They found a lot of back cuts and a lot of gaps. Beautifully executed.
Robinson giving the room. Rebounded by Paul. Davis not able to hit the turnaround. Here comes Selby. Now Elijah Johnson. So Johnson and Selby in the backcourt. Kansas without a point the last 4.5 minutes. Morningstar for three. Yes! A rainbow three for Brady Morningstar to stop the drought.
Big shot. Huge shot. This crowd now back into it. Kansas gaining momentum.
Touchdown. Oh! Set up by Head. So Crandall Head has come on, made a couple of nice passes leading to field goals.
Look at the backdoor cut from Bill Cole. Beautifully done, and the Illini fighting. Down four.
The Kansas lead is down to four. A couple of nice passes from Crandall Head to bring Illinois back into it. You can get coverage of the Division I Women's Basketball Tournament at NCAA.com/Final Four.
Marv, I'm not sure about that last timeout call by Bruce Weber because there's an under 12 coming on the next dead ball. Illinois was playing well. McCamey wanted to get back in the game, but at this point, I'm not sure why you use that timeout. Morris gets fouled. We're going to have another timeout right now, but the Illini now with just two left. And in a close game, that could come back to haunt Weber and the Illini.
So Marcus Morris to the line. He was fouled by Tyler Griffey. We'll be right back.
Bulls and Hawks.
This could be payback week.
Suns and Lakers.
The Lakers are in playoff mode now.
Tuesday at 8, presented by the United States Marine Corps on TNT.
Welcome back to Tulsa, Kansas, leading by four. On Thursday, Thomas Robinson turned 20 years old. On Friday, he celebrated his birthday with his extended family, his teammates, and his adopted mother, Angel Morris. He lost his mother in January at the age of 43. Not only did Lisa pass away, but so did his grandmother and grandfather just days earlier. But Angel Morris has lived up to her name. She not only providing comfort to Thomas, but also helping to raise little Jayla, who at the age of 7 has moved to Lawrence to be with her big brother.
Marv. What a difficult year for Thomas Robinson. And then in early February, sat out after undergoing surgery, repairing a torn right meniscus.
Yeah. So important to have your teammates around you when you go through something like that. And this really is a family for him.
Well, what a wonderful gesture by Angel Morris. Mm. Imagine handling twin boys. I mean, I grew up with two brothers. That was, a bizarre household. Yeah. Nothing personal there. I just wanted to happen to be with.
I was going to say, if you want to talk about this, maybe we should wait till later. But
yeah. But I'm thinking of twins. Wow. Kansas up 47-42. As we approach the halfway mark of the second half. Davis tried to fade away.
I just don't like the straight post-ups for Illinois because Davis and Tisdale just don't get good enough position because the Morris twins are so much stronger.
Selby getting it down low. Beautiful turnaround by Marcus Morris.
Now Illinois has to get movement. They've got to space the floor, get some back cuts, back picks, stretch this Kansas defense out. We will not have an advantage just running straight post-ups.
16 for Markeith Morris, 12 for Marcus Morris. And that's a tie-up, the possession arrow pointing in the direction of Kansas.
I think that's about the second turnover for Illinois in about the last 15 minutes. I mean, they've done a great job of taking care of the ball. Meanwhile, Marcus Morris, beautiful fadeaway. And Kansas threatening to stretch this thing out a little bit.
Dimitri McCabe is back on the floor. While he sat, Illinois made that brief run thanks to the good passing by Crandall ahead. Rare miss. Marcus Morris. Davis's pass deflected and picked off. Here comes Taylor. Beautifully done. And a foul. Got it to Marcus Morris down low. And Marcus will head to the line.
Kansas is looking sharp. Defensively, they're doing a nice job, and they're pushing the pace at every possibility. And the Morris twins have really taken over here in the second half.
Foul committed by Cole, his second. A reminder, the NBA returns to TNT for a special Tuesday doubleheader. Chicago Bulls, Atlanta Hawks, 8 o'clock Eastern time, followed by the Phoenix Suns and the Los Angeles Lakers. Brandon Paul reporting back.
I think Bruce Weber trying to get a little more offense on the floor. Cole, kind of the glue guy for Illinois. Not a big scorer, but Paul has the ability to break down the defense off the dribble. He and Richardson and McCamey have to create some offense here.
Kansas hitting 5 of 8 from the line. Jayhawk portion of the crowd on their feet. Kansas has taken a 9-point lead.
And Kansas, this is probably their best defensive lineup on the floor. The most speed and quickness, along with Robinson underneath with his size.
McCamey not able to operate to this point. McCamey sets it up for Tisdale, and he's fouled. What a difference it has been for Dimitri McCamey when you think back to what we saw on Friday night of the win over UNLV. Markieff Morris called on the foul. McCamey with a superb game, 35 minutes, 17 points, 3 threes, 7 assists, and a steal. He ran the show.
Yeah. Well, I had a chance to talk to Tom Crean, the Indiana coach. I said, what do you think of Illinois? First thing he said is McCamey is their energy source. He said if they can't get energy from him, then they struggle to score at times. And this is why. Look at that, 15-0 when he gets 7-plus assists. He had 7 the other night, but it's been a struggle here tonight for him to find anything, either shooting the ball or finding penetrating lanes to find teammates.
So Tisdale, an excellent free throw shooter, cuts it to 7. 13 points for Tisdale. Elijah Johnson in trouble, lost it. Paul took it away, and they have a breakaway. Richardson to the bucket. It's down to a 5-point lead, 10 points for DJ Richardson. Timeout, Kansas.
Amazing. This one possession in this game means so much. The easy lay-in for Illinois, and they're right back to within 5.
Kansas head coach Bill Self out of Edmond, Oklahoma, played college ball at Oklahoma State in his 8th year as the head coach of Kansas. Did win a national championship, won 7 straight regular season Big 12 titles. We mentioned earlier, this is an anniversary he'd like to forget about. A year ago to the day, they were knocked out of the NCAA.
And how about the fact that the coaching staff put the picture in Sports Illustrated of Farouk Dinesh's shot in each player's locker the other day as Reed misses the 3. And there was some debate about whether it was the right thing to do. Marcus Morris the other day said, I didn't want to see it. I took it down. And the question is, you know, does that make you more tight if you see all that? And Morris also said, we see it every day on TV anyway. They show it at the top of the NCAA broadcast.
McCamey again off, this time at a 3-point attempt.
And I'm sure Farouk Dinesh is happy to see it. What a moment for him.
Tough shot attempted by Marcus Morris, but the follow is right there.
What a play by Robinson. The putback. His energy is so important to this club.
Richardson. He was looking for a call. Here comes Tyshawn Taylor. Puts the move on. Waved off. Foul before the shot attempt. 7:37. Remaining second half, and Kansas holding on to a 7-point edge.
Energy, we cross the hall. Gravity, we bounce the ball. Tenacity, I'll beat you all. So make your play, and I'll watch you fall.
Zig. Greg Dumble in New York with a tournament update for you on TBS in Chicago. Florida State having a grand old time against Notre Dame. 7 of 12 from three-point land. That DeVita's Dulcis giving the Seminoles a 13-point lead, their biggest of the half. They lead at 34-23 at the break.
Back in Tulsa. That'll count on the follow. 16 points for Marcus Morris.
That's been the story. There's the points in the paint, the physical advantage that Kansas has in here. Look at the effort on the putback. And it's now 32-14 points in the paint for the Jayhawks.
Kansas 21 of 41 from the field. They're at 51%, so that matches their season average, which leads the nation. They also have 13 assists. They are among the leaders in the country in that category.
Yeah, I think they're second. They average 18 assists a game. This is just a really well-balanced offense, and they're at their best when they play inside out, which is what they're doing here tonight.
Richardson for three.
Wow.
Well, he's had the touch. 13 points for DJ Richardson.
And I talked earlier about it, the fact that he'd been slumping lately, but he got a couple of threes to go late in that UNLV game. And just seeing the ball go through the hoop a couple times obviously gave Richardson his confidence back.
That was his third three. Paul goes one on three and had it swatted away.
Bruce Weber can't believe it. Neither can Paul. Really good move to the hoop, but did not get the call.
Coming up on 6.5 to play in the second half. The winner goes to the Sweet 16. Tisdale with a good pass and a fast release by Davis.
Tisdale's really skilled as a big man, and he's a threat to shoot from that three-point line. Then he becomes a passer because the defense has to respond to him, and it really opens up the floor.
15 points for Davis. Morningstar for three. Loves that rainbow shot.
He does. Once again, Illinois somehow climbing its way back in. Every time it seems Kansas is about to break it open, the Illini fight back.
Kansas is led by as many as 12. Here's Richardson from long range.
And the crowd heaves a sigh of relief, this partisan Kansas fan base.
Taylor with the runner. The Morris twins all over the board. That's 18 points for Mark Keefe.
And Taylor's penetration led to that. I mean, he's going to get a missed field goal in the stat sheet, but it might as well be an assist because he broke down the Illinois defense, and that gave Morris the room for that putback.
And you can see why they shoot 51% from the field.
Yeah, they get everything in close.
Tisdale. He has not been able to do anything with that post move. Foul is called on Davis. Fifth team foul. Davis with his third. Illinois is facing a Kansas team that during the regular season was ranked second in the nation, number one seed in the region. They come off a win Friday night, second round over Boston University, 33-2 for the year. And two losses at home against Texas back in January at Kansas State. in mid-February. They have won their last 9 games.
And how about the job Bill Self has done here? 7 straight Big 12 championships. Ooh, Hisdale with the block, and the ball will remain with the Jayhawks. But just amazing the consistency of this Kansas program. As I said, 7 straight Big 10 regular season championships. They won 4 of the last 5 conference tournaments. No matter who's playing for Kansas, they just seem to always be good.
Nice look.
Morning Star finding Marquise Barnes.
And once again, Illinois faced with danger time, 9-point deficit.
Kansas fans on their feet. McKinney watched by Taylor. The tip missed by Tisdale. Here's Davis. Look out, it's a charging foul. Foul number 4 on Davis. And team foul number 6 on the Illini.
Markieff and Marcus have been phenomenal here in the second half at both ends. That time Markieff stepping in, getting great position and drawing that charge. They have just put on a show here in the second half.
Chris Weber sending on DJ Richardson, who had the hot hand. And he comes on for the senior, Dimitri McKamey. Try to trap Taylor. Last touch by Cole of Illinois.
Remember, this is the lineup that actually made a little push for Illinois with Crandall Head in the backcourt along with Richardson. So we'll see if they can give the Illini a little help here.
Well, Kansas is able to spread it out and they get it in. And Cole stays with the point guard, Tyshawn Taylor. Under 4 minutes to play. Here's Taylor setting it all.
Markieff Morris from Tyshawn Taylor.
Just beautifully done by Kansas. The execution, getting the ball moving from side to side. And now the turnover. And Illinois is falling apart.
Timeout called by the Fighting Illini.
Welcome back to Hack Job. Today, we're with the Gilberts. Okay, guys, are you ready to see your new kitchen?
Let's go!
Take a look!
Oh, here we go! It looks amazing!
He didn't do anything. We just put Bud Light on the counter.
Exactly!
It totally opens it up. We gave it a fun vibe. Clearly, this is a room people want to hang out
in. It's the sure sign of a good time. Just right taste of Bud Light. Here we go.
The landscapers are here. Nice!
Let's take a look at the Capital One Cup impact performance.
Kansas knew it had an advantage inside. This was the game plan the entire night. Go to the Twins, and they've done it every which way. We've seen putbacks. We've seen drop-off dunks, post-up moves. They have been spectacular. Look at the numbers together. They have just dominated. 22 points, 10 boards for Markieff, 17 and 12 for Marcus.
Just under 4 minutes to play, second half. The winner will head to San Antonio to face the Spiders of Richmond in the Southwest Regional. And that is called a tie-up, the possession arrow in the direction of Illinois.
Well, and if that winner is Kansas, you can expect about 20,000 Jayhawk fans to make their way to San Antonio as well.
Bill Self facing Illinois for the first time since his departure. He's been 3 years as a head coach at Illinois. He's had huge success everywhere. Although, as Tisdale able to get inside, not hit. He does point out when he started out at Oral Roberts, he did go through a very unpleasant 18-game losing streak, which he will never forget.
He said,
but he turned the program around.
He did, but we asked him, how'd that feel? He said, not very good, but he had a little better players now than he had then.
And this is the third time that he and Bruce Weber have met. They've each won a game against each other. Paul called on the foul. For instant analysis and highlights of every tournament game, log on to SI.com. So Tyrell Reed to the line. And the first of the doubleheader here in Tulsa. What a finish as Arizona beat Texas 70-69. Derek Williams, who did not have one of his better games, but had quite a finish. 17 points, 9 rebounds, and the winning basket on a three-point play.
A miraculous finish, particularly that five-second ball out of bounds. Texas had the two-point lead and the ball, and they couldn't get it in bounds. That's when Williams went to work.
Picked off by Morningstar. Kansas back in possession. So Arizona will go on to face the Blue Devils of Duke in Anaheim.
Oh! Marquise Morris with 24 points.
Well, if there was any tightness for the Jayhawks on Farouk Manesh Day, it's obviously gone. Everybody having a ball.
Is that a national holiday?
It's just a holiday in Iowa, I believe.
And Kamey on a reverse, his first field goal in quite some time. Stops a 10-0 run. We're coming up on 2 minutes to play. 13-point lead for the Jayhawks. They spread it out using the clock. Foul is given by Paul.
Well, Kansas has looked really, really good. I mean, they've looked like themselves here in the second half. And we've seen so many plays like this one. The penetration from Tyshawn Taylor. Remember, Bill Self at halftime told Craig Sager, he said, we got to get Taylor back onto the court because he's the one who can break down this Illini defense. And that's exactly what happened in the second half. Taylor has been really good. His numbers aren't going to be spectacular, but his penetration, I thought, changed this game.
7 points, 4 assists for Taylor. Most Sweet 16 appearances, in fact, 1985. You see Kansas on that very impressive list.
Yeah, and we I talked about it earlier. In the last 10 years, they have more NCAA tournament wins than any other program. This will be their 26th. Duke and Carolina each have 23. And yet, a couple early round losses always have this Kansas fan base nervous. And last year we talked about Northern Iowa, but this year it's a different story. They're playing well. They're on their way to the Sweet 16.
Checking out the game summary, see Illinois at 37%, 6 of 20 from downtown, and Kansas remains steady, 51% shooting, which is their season average, which leads the nation.
Yeah, and their defense has been great, and you look at the numbers for them this year. They've held their opponents to 30% three-point shooting throughout the year, and that's held form today because of their dominance inside. They haven't had to double team. Their guards have rotated quickly, and they look really, really good.
Illinois trying to put some pressure on. Did not matter. Taylor with the bucket and drew the foul. Let's go over to Craig.
Well, the winner of this game goes on to play the Richmond Spiders. I talked to Chris Mooney at halftime. He said that he gave the team the day off today, but he decided that he would go ahead and watch the game with his family, have a little private time with his wife, Leah, and brother-in-law, Chris. He said he was enjoying the game, just ready to go to work tomorrow with a game plan, but after watching the dominating performance in the second half by Kansas, maybe he's not enjoying it as much now in the second half.
Told he was enjoying the Steve Kerr commentary. Coaches often just shut the sound down.
I wonder how long coaches actually enjoy the Sweet 16 moment before they have to start thinking about playing against Kansas. You gotta enjoy it for a couple days, don't they?
Coming up on a minute remaining. And the foul is called on Cole. So for Illinois, victory in the second round against UNLV. The record will be 20-14 following tonight. They came into the tournament having their problems. They had dropped 10 of their previous 16. A lot of question marks. Team that had not won two straight since back in January.
They were so good early on, Marv. They had non-conference wins over North Carolina and Gonzaga. And close loss to Texas, but they looked really good. And then the inconsistency hit. And I think the key is that this is a finesse team, and they played in a powerful defensive conference in the Big Ten. And Davis and Tisdale just aren't big and strong enough to handle teams like Kansas and Ohio State. And once they hit the skids during that Big Ten season late, they lost their momentum.
Well, Davis able to hit the jumper, 17 points. And Illinois being booed for taking that timeout. Just 51 seconds away from Kansas advancing to the Sweet 16 for the fourth time in the last five seasons. And they'll play 12th seed Richmond in San Antonio next Friday. They have had only one meeting prior to what will take place next week. Took place in Lawrence. Richmond won the game 69-68 on a game-winning last-second jumper. Here's Taylor, who was fouled.
What year was that?
2004. And the last time that Kansas played in San Antonio was the 2008 Final Four. They defeated North Carolina in the semi, Memphis in the championship game to win the 2008 NCAA title. Mike Davis has fouled out, and that does it for Mike, a senior who has had an outstanding tournament, finishes with 17 points here tonight out of Alexandria, Virginia.
And Marv, they played hard tonight. Illinois really battled. They were on the verge several times of losing control of the game, and they kept coming back and cutting it to four or five. But in the end, they just weren't strong enough inside to handle the Morris twins and the penetration of Tyshawn Taylor.
Bill Self taking out Markeith Morris so he can hear it from the crowd. Markeith with 24 points, 12 rebounds. His twin brother, Marcus, 17-12. What a storied history when you look at the Kansas Jayhawks. They've been to 13 Final Fours, winning three. You go back to 1952, the team coached by Fog Allen.
There's Danny Manning, who captained that 1988 squad to the national championship. Had one of the great performances in NCAA championship game history against Oklahoma.
Bill Self pulling out his starting five. Brady Morningstar hearing it from the crowd along with Tyrell Reed.
Well, everything is shaping up pretty well for Kansas. I mean, you look at their region, and who could have guessed that they would be looking at Richmond, VCU, possibly Florida State if they maintain their lead over Notre Dame. And I understand they're up at 14, 40-26.
That game going on right now in Chicago over on TBS.
Compare that to the East region, where you've got Ohio State, Kentucky, North Carolina, and is it Marquette, I believe? Marquette is the other team. I mean, that's loaded over there. Kansas, I mean, it's not going to be easy, but they couldn't ask for anything more than what they're facing in San Antonio.
Marcus Morris just holding it at his chest, letting the clock run down. And for Bill Self, it'll be his fifth Sweet 16 appearance in eight seasons. He's gone to the Elite Eight three times, won the 2008 NCAA championship. Kansas ends the game on a 17-8 run over the last 6 minutes. As you look at the Southwest region, it will be Kansas facing the Spiders of Richmond in San Antonio. Notre Dame and Florida State continuing over on TBS. Thanks to our producer, Scott Cockerell, our director, Lonnie Dale, statistician Paul Evans. What a doubleheader here this evening. Highlighted by the first game, Arizona defeats Texas 70-69. Kansas advances to the Sweet 16 along with the Wildcats of Arizona. For Steve Kerr, Craig Sager, Marv Albert, sing long, so long from Tulsa. We'll take you to our studio and the road to the Final Four after this.
Hi again, everybody. Welcome back to our New York studios and the road to the Final Four here on TNT. I'm Ernie Johnson, joined by the usual cast of characters, Charles Barkley, Kenny the Jet Smith, Rick Pitino, and Greg Anthony. This was a day, as it nears its conclusion, in which we've seen three of the number one seeds move on to the Sweet 16. We've seen two teams from the city of Richmond make it to the Sweet 16. We see Illinois and Kansas tonight in a real battle as Kansas had to hold them off late and win that game 73-59. And Charles, your buddies, the Morris and Morris law firm, combining for 41-25.
You know what? I love watching Kansas play. I love the law firm. I still think, I got to tell you though, Ohio State was impressive today. Kansas is my pick, and I'm going to stick with it. But the best team I saw today was the Ohio State Buckeyes.
That's the guys that I kind of liked before it started, and I like the inside-outside combination that they've got, and I think you talked about how organized they are offensively, too. Very little wasted effort by that team.
You know, the thing about them is they really play well together. Like, they play for one another, and a lot of times you have a lot of teams with individual players who will kind of self-will it. Sometimes they feel like they got to make a play. They let the game determine what play is going to be made. That's why they shoot such a high percentage, because they get great rhythm shots. You know, when you let your offense dictate your shot selection, you're going to shoot a higher percentage. And Ohio State has mastered that thus far. It's going to be interesting to see in that matchup with Kentucky if they can disrupt that.
Hey, Coach, how long do you enjoy a win at this stage? And this is one of those kind of mile markers. Okay, now we're in the Sweet 16, and we've separated ourselves from the pack a bit. But how long do you enjoy it?
Probably a day. For the players, this is the week where they start getting a lot of attention on campus. They get a lot of attention realizing they're two games away from the Final Four. So the excitement really picks up when you start thinking Final Four is a reality with just two games.
How much prep have you been able to do at this point about your next potential opponent, as you've been playing and you're occupied with that? But are you getting some, hey, look, keep an eye on this. It looks like you may collide with this team.
You have the video person doing all the edits. You're ready to go that next day with your next opponent.
Kenny, thoughts on this day?
Well, I think, Coach, I'm going to go off of what Coach Pitino was talking about. I think this is a time where trust is the major issue. You have to trust that your system that you've put in place over these from October 15th, 16th, when you started practice, till now, actually works against anyone. And Dean Smith used to have a saying, you play the course. It's like golf. You have to believe that everything works. Don't worry about the videos. When we say send a guy down, we're going to trap a guy off a pick and roll. You have to believe that your teammates are going to be there. That's the difference between winning and losing in the last seconds, and we've seen it today. Guys not trusting that someone's going to come to the ball, so not trusting someone's going to cut the baseline off, and all of a sudden, you lose games.
Even as we speak, there is another game going on. It's on TBS. Look at this. Florida State leading Notre Dame now by 20 with under 15 minutes to go. Coach.
Ernie, I told you, Notre Dame cannot come back. If you play them close, if they have the lead, they're an outstanding ball club. They cannot come from behind because they don't have a press. Their defense is not good enough to make a comeback.
And they're taking on a team that's number one in the country in field goal percentage against Florida State opponents, shoot 36%. They are up by 20 in that game in a shocker. And if you want to catch that, you can turn to TBS. A reminder, our coverage of the regional semifinals begins on Thursday and Friday evenings at 6 Eastern with Infinity NCAA tip-off on True TV. Then we'll bring you primetime regional semifinal doubleheaders each night on CBS and TBS. Meantime, the tournament continues tonight with action on TBS with FSU and Notre Dame still in action. When all the game action concludes, stay tuned later tonight for Inside March Madness presented by Buick. It's on TBS. Coming up next on TNT, the original series, Leverage. Coach Pitino, thank you very much. It's been a blast spending time with you this weekend.
Had a great time. Charles made some great points. I'm licking my wounds. I got knocked out in the first round. Now the Big East is going under. I might as well just start swimming in the East River.
You know, I love you from conversations back we had today. You've had a big influence on my career. And I tell you that every time I tell you, thank you for that. And you guys watch Leverage. It is the bomb.
For my co-host, Greg Gumbel, and for all the guys, I'm Ernie Johnson. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you back here Thursday evening for the Sweet 16. Good night, everybody.